guys, and welcome back. Well, when you think that Tamar Braxton was through with Iyanla Vincent, think again. Now, the songstress Tamar Braxton is sharing new details about what went down during a taping of Braxton Family Values, where the singer claims she was blindsided by sexual abuse revelations of a family member shared with life and spiritual coach Iyanla Vincent. Now, in an exclusive interview with Houston's 97.9 The Box, Braxton says she had no idea her childhood sexual abuse would be a topic of discussion, adding that she never shared the shocking secret with anyone in her family. Now, it was never discussed, she told the radio host Mad Hatter. I didn't know that anyone knew. Now, while the abuse discussion with Vincent never aired, Braxton said the damage was already done. I feel like the responsibility was on Vincent to handle that. Now, to not mention it or not allow it to be said or have a conversation with me first, how about that, Braxton said. I'm mad at everybody. Now, Braxton said the abuse happened when she was 6 or 7 years old, after which Mad Hatter pointed out that someone in the family clearly was aware of what happened and discussed the incident with Vincent without Tamar's knowledge. And guess what I found out, Braxton chimed in. It's 1 in 3 people who suffer sexual abuse. That's crazy. And so it's definitely a situation that needs to be addressed and needs to be talked about. Now, it was last month on the Wendy Williams show that Braxton revealed she was molested by members on both sides of her family. The incident came up during the explosive meeting with Braxton's sisters, Tony, Tracy, Tawanda, Trina, and Miss Evelyn, who reached out to Vincent to help the family resolve its issues. Now, at one point, Tamar stormed out of the session after exchanging words with Vincent, who she accused of name-calling. Now, she later took to Twitter, fired off a series of tweets about the famous life coach, dubbing her the devil and a fraud. Now, Braxton later deleted the comments, but hey, as you know, the damage was already done. Now, Vincent is adamant about Tamar calling her the devil and a fraud, and Vincent has since rumored to be considering a defamation lawsuit against Braxton Family Values Network, WeTV, and its production company. I tell you, you know, but this is what I don't understand, which Tamar just acknowledged herself. Now, she's mad at Iyanla for bringing the alleged sexual abuse out, but why be mad at her? I think if it was me, I would be mad at the person who told Iyanla. Because it had someone in her family. Had to tell. You know, come on. Why are you mad at, you know, Iyanla when someone mentioned it? You know, y'all was there to straighten up your family dysfunction. So someone shared that maybe to say that's why you act like you do because of the views or whatever. So don't be mad at Iyanla. We would have never known until you went on the Wendy Williams show and told it. Hey, because they cut it out the script, so it never hit TV on Braxton Family Values. I tell you, Tamar is wild. I tell you. And now she's saying she's mad at everyone. But as you know, on that last episode, she made that old fake little cry and apologizing to everybody and not her family. Now saying that she's mad at everybody. As I said before, Tamar needs to get professional help. And even Iyanla has told a friend, allegedly, that Tamar was ruining her life and the life of others, which I do agree. I tell you, that Tamar Braxton is a piece of work. All right, guys, what do you think? I'm going to leave this one up to you. As always, thank you for watching my video. I hope you will like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And as always, I'm parting, y'all. Be blessed. Bye.